concept is terminology. 40 terms will be here. So this 40 times I will explain you today. First, terminology. Today concept is terminology. Whenever you are working with any software company, regularly we will use some terms or words that is called terminology, manual terminology, automation terminology different to manual terminology different to. Today concept name is terminology. Terminology. Today concept is terminology. First concept, what do you mean by defect products? Defective products. So first of all, we should know what are the main differences between defective products and defective products. Defective products. Very, very important concept, madam. Only terminology. Defective products. What is defective products? What is defective products? If at all the product is not justifying the sum of the requirements, but still usable. But still it is usable. Such type of defects is known as defective products. So if at all the product is not justifying the sum of the requirement. For example, I added one mobile phone, black color. I ordered one iPhone in black color, but they delivered white phone, but still usable. That means it is not justifying the customer some of the requirement, but still we can usable. So such type of defects is called defect products. Not only justifying the, if at all the product is not justifying the sum of the requirements, but still it is usable. So such type of defects is known as defective products. Okay, next, defective products. If at all the product is not justifying some of the requirements as well as it is not usable, not only just it is not satisfying the customer requirements as well as it is not working, so such type of defects is known as defective products. So whenever you are working with software company, regularly we will use some terms. One is defective products, second one is defective products. Defective products means it is not satisfying the some of the requirements, customer requirements, but still we can use it. So that is called defective products. So not satisfying the customer requirements as well as it is not usable, such type of defects is known as defective products. Next, quality assurance and quality control. What are the main differences between quality assurance and quality control? What is quality assurance? Quality assurance means QA. QA is the one of the department which checks each and every role in the organization. QA is the one of the department. Quality assurance means QA. So job requirement also, sometimes companies will ask you QA manager, QA engineer, QA test engineer, QA lead we need. So that what is mean? QA means quality assurance. So quality assurance is the one of the department which checks each and every role in the organization according to customer expectation, they are working or not. Each and every phase output document is properly coming or not. They will do check, they will do testing. So that's why that is called quality assurance. Quality assurance is nothing but each and every role in the organization according to customer expectation, they are working or not. Each and every phase output document is properly coming or not. They will do testing. So that people is called quality assurance people. Quality assurance, QA is the one of the department. They will check the each and every role in the organization according to customer expectations, they are working or not. Each and every phase output document is properly coming or not. They will do testing. So that's why that is called quality assurance. Next, quality control. QC is also one of the department which checks the developed product or its related parts based on the customer requirements. It is developed or not, they will do testing. So after developing the project, so once again we will do testing, quality control. Quality control people, it is also one of the department. After developing the application, once again they will do testing. So based on the customer requirement, product is developed or not, or that related parts it is developed or not, they will do testing. So that's why that is quality control. So quality assurance means during project we will do testing. Quality control means after developing the project we will do testing. So twice we are doing testing. So in this quality assurance and quality control, if you implement in any project, outcome document is output document, or outcome document is quality document. Outcome document is quality document. Why? Because all the companies will not perform quality assurance and quality control. If you perform two things, so outcome document is compulsory quality quality application. Why? Because during developing we are doing testing, after developing once again we are doing testing. So one twice we are doing testing, outcome document is quality document. Okay, right. Next term, NCR. NCR means non-confirmation rate. NCR means non-confirmation rate. Non-confirmation rate is a whenever the role is not following the process, then the penalty given by software company. Given by software company, that is called NCR. Whenever the simple we can say, whenever the role means employee. Whenever the role is, if we perform any irreparable mistake, so we can't repair. So that type of mistake is called irreparable mistake. So for example, glass we are keeping down, so automatically it will broke. So that means we can't once again we need to made as a glass. So that means, so each and every software company, whenever the role is irreparable mistake, if you do any irreparable mistake, if he is not following any company process, so each and every software company, they will give one penalty. That penalty is called NCR. NCR means non-confirmation rate. NCR means non-confirmation rate. Non-confirmation rate is whenever the rule is not following the process, then the penalty given for him is known as NCR. Right. Next, inspection and audit. What is inspection? What is audit? So inspection is a process of checking, and audit also process of checking. Inspection is also process of checking, and audit also process of checking. Inspection means it is a process of sudden checking conducted on the roles or departments without any prior intimation. Without any prior intimation, they will come and they will do checking on roles or departments. That is called inspection. So suddenly they will come and they will do checking. So on roles or departments, that is called inspection. Inspection is the It is a process of sudden checking conducted on the roles or departments without any prior intimation. They will do checking. That is called inspection. Next, audit. So audit also process of checking only on the, they will conduct checking on roles or departments with, they will give prior intimation well in advance. First of all, they will give you the information, so on so date we will come to your office or your organization, compulsory you should keep all the documents for audit. So they will give prior intimation in well in advance. That is called audit. Audit means it is a process of checking on roles or departments. So this is not sudden checking. So first of all, they will give prior intimation well in advance. So that day we need to arrange all the required documents. So that is called audit. Audit is nothing but it is a process of checking. They will give prior intimation well in advance, and they will come. They will check the roles or departments. That is called audit. There are two types of audit. One is external audit, second one is internal audit. External audit means external outside company people will do checking, so that is external audit. Internal audit means only internal resources they will do audit, so that is called internal audit. That is called internal audit. Next, CAPA. CAPA. CAPA means, CA means corrective actions. CA means corrective actions. CA means corrective actions. CA means corrective actions. PA means preventive actions. Preventive actions. Corrective actions and preventive actions. Corrective actions and preventive actions. CAPA. Corrective actions and preventive actions. So CAPA. CA. If at all the role has come to repairable situation, then that is called CA. CA means if it is any role, if you do repairable mistake, that is called corrective action. We can rectify the problem, we can solve the problem, that is called corrective action. So whenever the if at all a role has come to repairable situation, then CA will be taking care in order to connect the mistake, so we can rectify the problem. So that is called CA, corrective action. If it is any role, if you do any repairable mistake, so that is called corrective action. Next, preventive action. Whenever the roles commits irreparable mistake, then the preview the action should be taking care in order to prevent such type of mistakes in future. So preventive action. So just like glass is a preventive action, glass broken, so that is preventive action. So in future we need to take care, no need to happen once again. So that's the reason that is called preventive action. Whenever roles come to irreparable mistake, then the preview the action should taking care in order to prevent such type of mistakes in future. So such type of, we need to take care, so we need to prevent such type of mistakes in future. We need to prevent that such type of mistakes in future. Okay, next, corrective actions and preventive action. Corrective actions means repairable mistakes, so preventive actions irreparable mistakes. Next, SCM. Yesterday we discussed SCM, configuration management. There are two things. One is change control, other one is version control. Yesterday we discussed. So change control and version control. Next, common repository. Common repository. Next definition, common repository. Common repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total object information. So each and every software company, they will maintain common repository. Why? Because software job is not a permanent job. So today employee, tomorrow he may leave the company. So that's the reason total projects are pipeline and company growth rate, success rate, negative comments, so recently completed project information, total employees, grass, nifty, everything they will store in one repository. That is called common repository. Common repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total company information. So that is common repository. Simply we can say common repository is basically a server which can access by only authorized people. If you want stored info, if you want to access the stored information, compulsory we should have username and password, then only we can access that information. So using that username and password, we can access that information. So that is called common repository. So here we have two facilities. One is downloading, second one is uploading. We can download the information if you have correct username, correct password. If you are authorized person, we can download the information. If you are authorized person, we can upload the information. We can download the information, we can upload the information from common repository. Best example, VSS or CVS. VSS means Visual Source Safe. VSS means Visual Source Safe. CVS means Concurrent Version System. There are best examples for common repository. Common repository. Common repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total company information. So company information we will store in one repository. Simply we can say it is a server or folder. We will keep the all the company information. So if you want to access that information, compulsory we should have username and password. Using that username and password, we can access the information that is called common repository. We can download, we can upload the information. Best example VSS and CVS. Next, baseline projects. Baseline project means finalizing the projects. Baseline projects means finalizing the projects. That project is finalized. So that is ready to delivery. That is ready to delivery. That application is called finalized projects. That is called finalized projects. Baseline projects. Finalized projects is called baseline project. Baseline is nothing but it is a process of finalizing the document, finalizing the projects. That is called baseline project. Next term, baseline. Next term, baseline. Baseline means finalizing the project. Baseline. So what are the documents, what are the projects are finalized, he will listed, they will listed out here in this section, that is finalized documents. And publishing. And next one, publishing. Next one, publishing. 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 After finalizing the document, so we need to publish the document to market. Publishing is, it is a process of making the finalized documents available to the relevant resource by uploading them into common repository with a special icon representation. Before delivery, so before delivery, that object information or that project information we will store in common repository with special icon representation. For example, X project recently completed, that information the software company people will not delete, so they will keep in common repository. In future, if they get any similar project, they want to use that information, they want to complete that particular project very easily or quickly. So that's the reason before publishing, after finalizing the document, before publishing, they will keep in common repository with the special icon representation. Next to review. Next to review. What is review? Review is nothing but it is a process of checking or process of studying. Some people they will do review. Review means it is a process of checking, depending upon the role involved in it. So for example, you wrote some data, you wrote some code, I am reviewing. That means, so I am checking or I am studying. So based on the role involved, depending upon the roles involved in it, that is called review. Next, review report. While doing review, while studying the requirements or any code, if you have any doubt, we will list out in review report. So review report means it is a list of doubts. While doing review, if you have any doubts, we will list out in one report, that is called a review report. Review report means list of doubts. Next, peer review. What do you mean by peer? Peer means it is a colleague. Peer review. It is a process of checking conducted by the colleague at the same level. Same level person, if you do checking, that is called peer review. In the same person. So peer review means colleague review, same level, same designation people will study that document, that is called peer review. Peer review report. So peer review report means while doing review, so the peer review report means Peer review means it is a list of doubts. Peer review report. It is the outcome document of peer review which contains the list of all the comments given during the peer review. What are the comments? What he while doing review, he had some doubts. So that doubts or comments he will listed out in the peer review report. Okay, next slippage. So for example, each and every software company, they will give some work. So just they will give time also. You should complete this work in 8 hours, but you did that work in 12 hours. So that 4 hours is slippage. Slippage means extra time. That is the extra time. Slippage means the extra time to accomplish a task is known as slippage. The extra time to accomplish a task is known as slippage. Slippage. Next to escalation. Review, peer review. Review is over. Review report. Peer review report. Peer review report, slippage means slippage. Next to slippage means the extra time to accomplish a task is known as slippage. Next to escalation. It is a process of intimating the issue related information to the next level of authorities, usually is known as escalation. So one level to other level, we are intimating the information. One level to other levels, we are intimating the information. So that is called escalation. Escalation means we are intimating the information to one level to other level. That is called escalation. So metrics means it is a clear measurements of a task. Metrics means clear measurement of a task. Next definition. Traceability matrix. Very important definition. So that's the reason I will write you definition also. Traceability matrix. Very important definition in entire manual testing. That is traceability matrix. Traceability matrix. What do you mean by traceability matrix? It contains. Hello. Madam. Lavanya. It contains some table of. It contains some table of linking information which is used for very important definition ma. So I am writing definition. It contains some table of linking information which is used for tracing back for the reference whenever there is a questionable situation. Traceability matrix is nothing but it contains some table of linking information which is used for tracing back for the reference whenever there is a questionable situation. What is the traceability matrix? I will tell you. This is very, very important, man. That is the reason I wrote a definition also. First, based on FRS, we will study the customer requirement. That is called FRS. Based on FRS, we will write the use cases. Based on use case, we will write the test case. Based on the test case, we will list out very, very important points. We will list out that is detailed test case. Detailed test cases. In the detailed test cases, they will prepare master test cases. Master test case. If you execute the master test case, we got the defect. We got the defect. So first FRS. FRS base. I am writing three use cases. One use case, based on one use case, we are writing three test cases. One, two, three. So in this very, very important, I am detailed test cases. I'm prepared list out detailed compulsory. We need to execute the test cases. That is the detailed test case. In this very detailed, very compulsory important test case, I'm list outing here. I'm executing this one, we got defect. I'm executing this one, we got defect. Then we can trace back for the reference. We can trace back for the reference. So that is called traceability matrix. That is called traceability matrix. Traceability matrix is nothing but it contains some table of linking information which is used for tracing back for the reference whenever there is a questionable situation. From which requirement we got the defect, we can find out. From which requirement we got the defect, we can find out. From one requirement we got the defect. So we got defect, we can trace back for the reference. From which requirement we got the defect, we can trace back for the reference. That is traceability matrix one use. Second use, all the requirements covered or not, we can find out. If it is mapping is there, that requirement is covered. So 2 and 3, there is no mapping. So that means it is not covered. So there is no mapping. So that means it is not covered. It is not covered. So that is traceability matrix use. That is traceability matrix use. Okay, right. Next, release. Next definition, release. Next definition, release. Next definition, release. So release. When we can call release, it is a process of sending the application from the development department to the testing department or from the company to the market. From company to the market. Recently, one model is released. So recently one model is released. Recently that movie is released. We can say. And we got the developers released one build. Developer released one build. We can say release. What is the main differences between release and delivery? We should know. Release means it is a process of sending the application from the development department to the testing department or from the company to the market. From company to the market. So that is called release. Next, delivery. Next, delivery. What is delivery? So delivery is nothing but it is a process of hand over the application from the company to the customer. Hand over the application to the company, from the company to customer, from company to customer. It is a process of hand over the application from the company to the customer or client. And or we can say from the market to the client, from market to the client. Oh sir, I ordered 100 kg rice. Yes sir, I delivered. So that is called from the market to the customer or client. Or we can say delivery is the process of hand over the application from the company to the client. Company to the client. I delivered you said 100 kg rice, so we delivered. That time we can use. Next to SRN. SRN means next. SRN means software release note. Software release note. It is a note prepared by the technical department people. SRN means software release note. It is a note prepared by the technical department people and sent to the testing department people. And this document contains some following. It contains some points. That is called SRN. SRN means software release note. SRN means software It is a software release note. It is a note prepared by technical department people and to send it to testing department people. This document contains some fields like build path information. Next, test data path information and deployment document path information. Known issues path information. During delivery, what we need to cover, everything he will prepare here in the section, that is SRN. SRN means software release note. It is a note prepared by technical department people and they will send to the testing department people. In this we have some fields like build path information. Build path information, where exactly we can get the build. If you want check the build, we can check it. So build path information. Test data path information. Test data, where is the test data, how to test this build. So test data path information. Deployment document path information, how to deploy the application into client environment. They will provide installation document, that is called deployment document path information. Next, known issues path information. What are the documents, what are the known issues? Regularly he will face some problems, so compulsory we need to provide known issues document. That information, release manager name, release date, build number, version number, project name, module name, everything we have in SRN. SRN means software release note. Next, SDN means software delivery note. It is a document which contains some fields like user manual, known issues document. User manual, known issues document. This is the document prepared by the team members under the project. It is the under the project manager guidelines. So the team members will prepare the software delivery note. In this we have 2 points. One is user manual. Second one is known issues document, user manual and known issues document. So that is SDN, software delivery note. Next, prototype means It is a roughly and rapidly developed model. If you want to take the requirements from customer, if you want to give the requirement to the company, so we will follow one document that is called a prototype. Prototype is nothing but it is a roughly and rapidly developed model. Next one is benchmark. This term usually we will use in compared purpose, benchmark. So we will use in compared purpose. We will use in only compared situation. We will use benchmark. Next, change request. Change request. First customer will give the FRS document. So middle of the project, you want to do any changes to the application. So first of all, you need to go to software company. You need to fill the change request template. Each and every software company having request change request template. So first you need to fill the information. If it is any possible, they will do changes. That is called change request. So each and every software company, they will give one chance, one or two chances. Within one or two chances, they, if you want to change the any requirement, you can change it. After that, if you want to change any requirement, they will not do any changes. So that is called change request. Next, impact analysis. Next, impact analysis. So they will analyze the, whenever giving the change request template, then they will analyze impact analysis. Already whatever he is saying, that part is developed or not. If it is developed, they will not do any, they will not take any change request. So if it is not developed, not at all, then they will take the request. They will take the request. That is called impact analysis. Next, test suite. Next, test suite. Test suite. Test suite is nothing but it is a combination of number of test cases or regression test cases or retest cases. We can say it is a combination of regression and retest cases, or we can say simply it is a combination of all the test cases. Next, test bed. What is test bed? Test bed is nothing but it is a combination of test suite and test environment. Test bed is nothing but it is a combination of test suite and test environment. Next, defect age. The next way, next defect age. What is defect age? Defect is the time gap between the opening date and the closing date of the defect. Opening date and closing date of the defect is called defect age. Next, latent defect. Latent defect. Latent defect. The defect found date after some releases is known as latent defect. After finding the defect, if they do any delivery, that is called latent defect. Latent defect. Next, walkthrough. Each and every software company, they will conduct informal meetings. So on roles, that is called walkthrough. That is called walkthrough. 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 Walkthroughs. Each and every software company, they will conduct informal meeting, that is called walkthrough. Next, code walkthrough. So some people, after developing the code, so that code is correct or not, they will do code walkthrough. So it is a process of checking conducted on the source code document in order to confirm whether it is developed according to the coding standards or not. While developing the application, developers for effect, they should follow coding standards. Then only application performance is very good. So code walkthrough is nothing but it is a process of checking conducted on the source code document in order to confirm whether it is developed according to the coding standards or not. Next, code optimization or fine tuning. It is a next code optimization. Code optimization. Code optimization. Code optimization. Code optimization means optimization or fine tuning. So after writing the code, so this code is properly or not, perfectly they are following coding standards or not. So obviously the code, they will do checking. If it is code is not good, once again they will do fine tuning. So they will set the code, that is called code optimization or fine tuning. Next to PPM, periodic project meeting. PPM means periodic project meeting. So it is meeting conducted in the periodically in the software company. In this meeting, they will select about some fields like percentage covered in the during the, how much percentage covered in the during that period, how much percentage not covered in the in this during period, what are the tasks completed, total defects, slippages, reason for slippages, technical issues, HR related issues, they will discuss. That is called PPM. PPM means periodic project meeting. Next term,
PPR, periodic project report. So it is a report prepared by the team lead before the PPM conducted. So what are the points they need to discuss? He will list it out in the PPR, periodic project report. So what are the this document prepared by project test lead. So what are the points we need to discuss? He will list it out here in the section, that is PPR, periodic project report. Next to MOM. MOM means minutes of meeting. Minutes of meeting means, so it is the output document of any meeting which contains the list of already discussed points, important points they discussed in the meeting. He will tell that minute of meeting will show you what are the main concepts they discussed, what are the main topics they covered, and what is the main important points. He will list it out in the report, that is called minutes of meeting report. MRM. Management representation meeting. It is a meeting so conducted in the software company. In this meeting, high level management people will be participate. MRM, management representation meeting. In this meeting, they will select about, they will discuss about company, success rate, growth rate of the company, projects that are recently signed off, projects that are in pipeline, customer negative comments, and future plans. What is the main company individual appraisals and internal audit reports they will discuss. That is called MRM, management representation meeting. Next patch. Patch is nothing but whenever the test engineer suspend the build, then the developers will rectify the problem. So that is called patch. So we will raise the defect. So that means they will not develop new application. We will raise the defect. That means they will not develop new button or new application. They will do some changes or rectify the problem, and they will sending to testing department again. That is called patch. These are the 42 terms. So this is the terminology in manual testing. In manual testing, we will use these are the extra terms we will use in software company. Compulsory you should know. So once read it, madam. Already I have sent you notes. Once read it. So it is very, very important. So terminology also very, very important. When we can call which term. So each and every point is important. Read it. So tomorrow we can complete manual testing. Tomorrow last class of manual testing. So after that we can enter into Selenium. So tomorrow last class of manual testing. So this recorded file I will send you. So just theory part, madam, manual testing theory part. So wherever you go, you need to start your career with manual testing only. So something bore. So that's the reason I'm not taking more hours. So just you can't concentrate on only theoretical part. So if it is automation, we can concentrate. But if it is manual testing, only theory part, you can't concentrate. But manual is a base. Wherever you go, you should start your career with manual testing only. If you have 10 years experience also, once again, they will give manual project only. So manual is base. So you should concentrate. Okay, sometimes you can get sleep also while attending this class, but compulsory, it is very, very important. Ma, Vaishnavi madam, got it?
Yeah. Help.